Hi, and welcome to the Real United States video blog. And here we are in Orlando, Florida. This is our first episode here. And I wanted to introduce you to one of the places that we like to especially come, and that's to the Asian district in Central Florida. We're pretty much in downtown Florida. And we like to come here where a lot of the Asian markets is. These are markets representing largely the Pacific Rim, from places that represent products for Thailand and Singapore and China and Taiwan, Korea, Japan, along the Pacific Rim. And they sell a lot of products that you can't really find in the average normal American grocery store that we've come to rather fond of. So we're here at Donga Imports, Donga Grocery, and we're gonna hopefully be able to show you a little bit of our shopping trip as we pick up some goodies inside. One of the things that we've come to particularly enjoy is a style of a Japanese noodle called udon. And this is about the only place that I know of in Central Florida where you can find it. There may be other places, but this is where we like to come, is the Donga to get our udon noodles. And I usually buy the big packages because, well, I didn't get this size suck in air, so we buy a lot of it. And usually, these are the ones that we get here, and you can see I get them in 3-pound packages. That usually, and they're $4.99, $5. I'll try and do the conversions for you on the screen on that. And what are we looking at? We want a couple of those, maybe? You can do all kinds of wonderful different dishes with this. This is very, very good. It's a wheat noodle, a little bit different than maybe the egg noodles that the type of pasta you might associate with Italian cooking. And they're a much thicker noodle than what you see than somen noodles. So they swell up quite a bit, so they get pretty beefy. So I'll get myself about 3 kilos of that. Let's see, 6 pounds? A little less than 3 kilos. And you can see that they have all sorts of other. Now this is one of the interesting things about shopping in an Asian grocery store, is it makes me appreciate how illiterate I am. Now, fortunately, many of the packages are labeled in both English and their native language, but I mean this really does give me an appreciation for what illiteracy is like, because I'm a fairly literate man and I have no idea what that says. Can't even put it right back in the right place. So and for those of you that are interested, you can get the udon in smaller packages. These are 8.8 ounce, 250 grams. And that's $3, and I can get 3 pounds for $5. So that's why I buy in the bigger package. It's a much better deal, and it keeps forever. And they have quite a nice selection of sake and different plum wines and the sorts of things you'd see from countries in the Pacific Rim. Rather fond of the plum wine. I've never had the Kikkoman, but the Fuki is quite nice. I do like this. This is actually made in Japan, whereas the Kikkoman is made in the United States. So I usually like to buy products from their native countries when I can, because they have the most experience and it's usually the best. But really, really like the Fuki plum. Now, we've been coming here for quite a number of years, and very, very, very fond of this place. They always treat us very, very nicely here. As you can see, there's, again, more kinds of tea than you could possibly imagine. And again, I feel terribly, terribly illiterate. But fortunately, it does read in English here that that's black tea. Now, the problem, of course, is that all black teas are not created equal, so there's certain ones that I like and that Beverly likes, and in particular, the one that I happen to like is the Fujoy black tea. This particular brand I really, really like. It's distributed by a company here in the United States, but this is clearly a product that comes from the Pacific Rim. But I don't see the Fujoy brand, just the jasmine green, China jasmine green. Yeah, it's not looking good. So we may have to resort to another store for, this is kind of cool. This is jasmine tea that's actually glass. These are actually glass containers. I thought it was maybe plastic, but that is actually a glass container that has a jasmine tea sort of thing in it. And another one that's, what does it say? Rose tea kun yin. So these are they use rose hips, the little dried rose buds in making tea. And just about everything you can possibly imagine for tea. And still packaged in metal too, some of them still packaged in tin cans. This is a rather nice one here. We've had this a few times. It's a jasmine tea. That's quite pleasant. So we're looking for a particular type of seasoning. It's a marinade we use for, I think I found it. There we are. A Chinese barbecue.
I think so. Roast pork seasoning. Either that or roast pork seasoning.
Which is a very similar. How many of these you want?
I'd like two of those.
They're $1.09. So what's that, Sergey? About 30 rubles or 30 rubles and a few kopecks. I'm not even sure I'm pronouncing kopeck right, but you know, those little coins you guys got. It's noodle heaven. The noodles we got on the other side of the store are specifically, those are Japanese style noodles. These are noodles from other parts of the Pacific Rim that are, I don't even know where some of these are from, but these, for example, are a product of Vietnam. And so cellophane noodles, which is actually made in the United States, but spinach noodles, again, they're kind enough to put it both in their native language where it's manufactured and in English down here, and in both avoirdupois and metrics. So on the weights, and these are actually a from Taiwan, Republic of China. So as I said, quite a wide variety of products from countries all over the Pacific Rim are represented here. And so, I mean, virtually every kind of noodle. This is like macaroni, only it's made out of rice flour. It's rice pasta macaroni. This is actually pretty good. It tastes quite a bit different than a normal durum semolina flour macaroni. Durum semolina flour is a special durum hard, is a hard wheat that kind of typically used in Italian pastas, where you're going to find a lot more soft wheat noodles or rice noodles in Asian markets. And I think that's going to about do us. Let's see if I can find it. Here we are. Now, this, I really don't know how to explain this. This is grass jelly. And when I say grass, I mean, you know, like your lawn. And I don't particularly care for it, but it's very grassy tasting. Not unlike reaching under your lawnmower and that wet grass that you get into there and taking a big mouthful of that. But I tried it once. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, way down here in the corner, hidden far away, this is soy sauce. Now, this may seem like a big bottle of soy sauce to many Americans. I don't know what part of the world you're watching this in, but this is the brand of soy sauce that we buy. It's called a vegetarian soy sauce. I don't buy it because of that. I buy it because it has a very mild, very full flavor, but very, very not salty. And this is, this bottle's a little misshapen, but excellent. Really, really, really good product. Here we have bamboo shoots, which are prepared. They've already been boiled and rinsed and boiled and rinsed, so they're ready for consumption. You can't just harvest fresh bamboo shoots. This is something we had talked about with the air potatoes episode, that bamboo shoots are one of those things that are poison unless they're prepared properly. And these have already been prepared for sale. So you just take them home, cut them up, and use them. They also have them shredded. And sliced. This is a rather interesting product that you can't find in most Western grocery stores. And I've never tried to prepare this because I don't know how, and I'd really like to learn how. This is a banana blossom. This is the blossom from a banana plant that would eventually open up and become a stalk of bananas. And they are apparently quite delicious, but I don't know exactly how to prepare them. So, but I'm still young enough to learn. Okay, well, we finished our shopping at Donga, the first store we're going to go to, and I remembered on the way out, stacked right by the door in big pallets, is we needed some rice. And, you know, when you buy rice at an Asian market, you don't buy in little tiny bags, so 25 pounds, 11.4 kilograms, and you'll notice that this is packaged specially for Donga products. Production here, So this is packaged by the manufacturer, especially for export to this company. So this is really good. It's jasmine rice. It's got a little jasmine flavor to it. Very nice. We like it, so, and obviously we eat a lot of it. So we'll see you at the next store. And here we are at the other, and I'm not even gonna pronounce that because if I do, it'll come out sounding very dirty in English. Here we are at the other major Asian grocery store in downtown Orlando. This is probably one of the largest, if not the largest, Asian grocers in Orlando, Florida. Like this store a lot too. They got some really cool stuff that they don't always have at the other store. You notice the large classic Chinese lion statues both sides of the door. Very pretty, very ornate, with the one paw here on top of the smaller version of itself. Oh, I love coming here. This is it's a fun place to shop. Unfortunately, I always spend more than I should. This is not uncommon in an Asian grocer to see a shrine in the background behind me here. A religious shrine. It's often to bring prosperity or good luck, safety, those sorts of things to the owners of the establishment. So, well, as you'll see, we've come to the tea aisle, and I've actually found the last package of the kind we like, the China green tea. And this is $6, $5.99. Everything's 99 in the United States. They don't ever roll it over to an even number for some reason. But I didn't want the China jasmine tea, so this is just the plain. And the nice thing about this is it comes with a bonus 18 pack of these six different, two of each of these six different, or three of each. Six times three is 18. So these six types of other green teas and teas that come along with it. So this is kind of a bonus. And then we found these little candies that we like. And they give you a couple of these when you go to the Chinese takeout place near our home. And so if you want to buy a whole bag of them at there, it's $5, whereas here it's two for $5. So they're a mango guava. Sorry, my bad. A guava. A little hard candy about the size of a peanut, and each individually wrapped. And really, really nice little after dinner thing to kind of cleanse the palate, a little sweet. So we're getting a couple of packages of those. Another one of the interesting things that you find in these stores is this just says sea trout fish pieces. But what this is the swim bladder from inside of the fish that's been flash fried in hot oil. And it swells up like a rice cracker. It's they're pretty good. It's kind of like fried pork rinds, which are popular here in the United States. I don't know what part of the world you're watching this from, but again, this is actually pretty good. It sounds weird, a swim bladder that's been flash fried, but they're crispy, like a potato chip maybe, or but closest thing you could compare them to here in the United States would be fried pork rinds, and you can see that they come in, well, quite a variety of different species, and they're not cheap. That's $26 for that many, so I don't think we'll be having fried fish bladders today. But they come in really big bags. That one right there, folks, is $80. So it's not a cheap thing. I've only had it once in my life, so. See, we get dried mushrooms. These appear to be shiitake mushrooms. Sliced what I believe are oyster mushrooms. Okay, we finally found the other type of mushrooms that I was telling you about. They're they're called a wood mushroom. There's no real good translation for it into English. They grow out in the woods. They're a big feathery like. They're very nice. If you can find these fresh, they're very nice. They're, I know them as matsutake mushrooms, but they're very light and very thin veined mushrooms that have a very delicate flavor, almost no flavor at all. They absorb whatever broth you put them into to reconstitute them, and that's like I said, there's really no good English word for that. They're matsutake. And another thing that I had mentioned, which doesn't have a good English translation for, is this, which I swear to God is called bamboo fungus, but this is actually a kinugasa mushroom. And it's a little hollow. These are dried, of course. But it's a hollow tubular stem with a gossamer kind of a top. And when you reconstitute these, then you can stuff the hollow tube with a stuffing using a piping bag, like a cake decorating piping bag, and deep fry them. And these are quite delectable. That's $11. But you have no idea how far that goes, because they're all neatly tied with a rope. Here you see this, these swell up a lot when you re-soak them, and then of course get quite large, so you can stuff quite a bit in them. So that's enough to feed a couple of us for, you know, like a year. So for as often as we would have them, that's kinugasa mushrooms or bamboo fungus. So something that you don't come by just everywhere. But I have had those, and I've made dishes with them where I stuffed them, and it turned out quite nicely. You fry them in peanut oil, and here's more of the matsutake. Again, matsutake, a lot of these come dried because you can't ship them across the ocean fresh. They won't keep, and you can't freeze them. So many of them will come to you dried. And there's any one of number of, well, simply called black fungus. And these, despite how you may feel about color in your food, actually are quite pleasant. We use these in soups. But again, you gotta go easy on these, because a little handful, when you put them in water and you soak them up, they swell up about 10 times size. So you go easy when you're making these. Here's something that you don't see a lot, certainly in the northern United States, or, well, except in Asian grocers, but you don't see even in Western grocers, in the regular, normal Western grocery stores, and that's palm sugar. This is, I'm not sure exactly what species of palm this is extracted from, but it's extracted from a palm tree. Probably a sago palm or something like that, and it's not granulated like you would think of. Most sugars come granulated. This is a solid brick of sugar, palm sugar, and you can buy it in a kind of a real viscous, like still almost solid form in a glass jar. So that's I'm trying to remember. I think we've used this once. It's pretty nice. But palm sugar. Here's another interesting thing that, as far as I know, there's no English word for it. It's called mochi. And it's literally a little solid brick of rice flour. And you bake these, and they puff up and be almost like a cream puff. I know there's a cool French word for that, but like a cream puff, these puff up, become very light and thin and crispy with this big hollow air spot in that you can slice open and stuff full of things. And so you've got this crispy, light rice cracker shell with the stuffing in it. But when you get it just ready to cook, it's literally like a little rectangular brick of rice that's been processed and pressed together, and it's got some other ingredients in it, I'm sure. And if I wasn't illiterate, I could tell you what's in it, but pretty illiterate when it comes to this. So, but I do know how to cook it, and it's really good. All right, we just came out of the last grocery store that we were telling about, and the New Year's coming. Well, the Gregorian New Year or the Julian New Year, not sure which it is, but the Chinese New Year won't be until around the beginning of February. But they were nice enough to give us a calendar that for just as a thank you for being a customer. Got this kind of hard to see here through the plastic. I'll show it to you maybe when we get home, but all these beautiful fish and cute little characters on it and whatnot, and it's got all the dates in both regular Arabic numerals, and that's what those are, is Arabic numerals, by the way. And then it also has it in its various other Asian languages, in Chinese and Vietnamese, I recognize, and I think Japanese. And so there's quite a bit of information here, regardless of what language you may speak. And that was just a gift for shopping there. So I thought that was very nice of him, and I told him thank you in his native Vietnamese, and he was quite pleased. So we'd like to thank you for watching this episode of the Real United States video blog. We hope you enjoyed this episode. We hope you'll take time to pick subscribe and join us for future episodes. You can always find us on Facebook. We'd be happy to have you join us there. Or you can join us on MoTube and get instant updates via text to your mobile cellular phone. If you have questions or comments, please leave them in the comments section below. We'll be happy to get back to you just as soon as we possibly can. And as always, thank you for watching.